Bruce Bauer. I write about behavioral sciences for Science News. So I cover everything from psychology to archaeology, anthropology. if it's about human beings and how we think and behave, then that's pretty much what my beat is. Psychologists are currently going through a period of much angst and worry over whether their science can really be found to repeat their findings, whether it's valid, are they really onto something. There's much discussion now about how psychology should pursue this issue and how can it be solved. This is something that we are going to cover quite a bit in Science News because it applies not just to psychology but to many areas of science right now. For scientists, reproducibility is very important because what it means is that when they get one particular finding, it's important to know that people can find the same thing in independent labs with independent researchers trying to see if the finding holds up. So one aspect of the way psychologists currently do business with significance testing is to focus purely on the average scores of groups and to compare the averages of one group to another, and if one average is considered to be statistically significant or different enough from the other group, then they consider that to be an effect. But averages can hide just as much as they reveal. And as we've recently reported in Science News, it can be very instructive to look not at averages, but at individual differences. So when researchers recently looked at individual differences between young children, learning what they call theory of mind, or how to understand and make inferences about what others are thinking and feeling, the children show very different rates of learning, even over a couple of years from age 3 to 5. And I think right now, given a lot of the controversy and the anxiety over significance testing and lack of reproducibility, there may be more of a focus on individual differences, which would be a very healthy move for the field.